to work on a design. So I figured, why not turn the camera on and do it for everybody? How's everyone doing today? Okay, I have 359, so I think I will get started. I was just playing around with some designs that we have recently learned. That sounds nice, Nancy. It's supposed to be, I think, in the 70s here in Pennsylvania, which is a very nice Memorial Day. But I haven't checked the weather in a few days, so I don't know if that's changed. I'm the kind of person that just wakes up in the morning and looks at the weather outside, especially in the winter. But it's supposed to be nice, so I hope it is. Okay, so we left off Tuesday with these two designs. I'm trying to fit everything on my desk here. I need a bigger desk. And got a couple things I wanted to share with you today. So we're gonna jump right in with two very easy designs today. So again, I have my sketchbook. We are, I believe, still in the yellow until next Friday. I'm terrible. I don't follow it as much as I should. But I'm the president of our local library board, and we are... Our library director planned instructions on how we are going to operate the library. In the yellow, our museums, we are thinking that they are not going to be opening as quickly as we had hoped, but we're kind of going in on an as-needed basis. So I don't know what to say. I think some of us are opening, but we're in like southwestern central Pennsylvania, if that makes sense to you. Bedford, Blair, Cambria, Somerset, Fayette, and Westmoreland counties are the regions that the museum serves, and we are all right now in the yellow, hoping for green next week. So we're going to start with our border. Today's fairly easy. I have a number 5 micron pen, but you don't need this. You just need a sheet of paper and a pencil if that's what works for you. And this is going to be a very simple one. We're going to start here. I'm going to bring this down and touch the bottom of my border, and I'm going to quit. So essentially we're doing a backward six. This is a design that would be a good filler for a background if you needed it. So our next step, we're going to create a series of parallel lines, I guess, more curved in our little circle spot here. Now, if you want, you can color those in, which I will do fairly quickly here. Mine are not going to be perfect, but you'll get the gist of it. I hope we can open up soon, Nancy. It's as much as I like being at home, and I appreciate the opportunity to be working from home, which I really do. It'll be nice to kind of go back to the office. Some days I feel like I work too much, and then some days I feel like I could be working more. So it's hard to find that balance, I guess. Now I just went and made my little stripe a little thicker, just because I can. So our next step, what I want you to do is pretty much going to start from here, and we're going to work on this top right section. Again, kind of curving our lines. I could probably make it a little bit thicker. It should have made it a little thicker, actually, but that's okay. And we will just keep with that curved line. So what I'm going to do, you're kind of doing the opposite. I see some new faces watching. So we're kind of doing the opposite. And almost like op art, give you a little bit of a optical illusion. But you know what? For our purposes, I have a marker that I'll use to fill in those spaces, so I can do it a little bit quicker. We are creating Zentangles if you're new. Zentangles are the art of drawing structured patterns to create artwork. It can be very therapeutic and relaxing, which is why we're here. So every day we learn a few, or every day that I'm here, we learn a few different Zentangle patterns that you can put together. I'm actually going to just bring this down a little farther. If you plan this one out right, you can have a lot of fun with it. Although I'll admit this isn't one of my favorites. But it does, I mean, it does look nice from a distance. So you're essentially just creating a striped design. But you're giving yourself a fun string in there to break up that pattern. I might go over here too and just... So when we get to this section, again, what we want to try and do is kind of do the opposite from the section that it's up against or next to. So it all depends on your design and how your lines are falling. And again, you know, there are no mistakes, so just do the best you can. And I will come this way. And fill in. Again, I'm not taking my time and filling in my lines as best as I could. But I could probably spend 20 minutes doing that, and I don't think anyone really wants to watch that. But I'll go and I'll put my last section up here. Again, still maintaining a little bit of a curve to your line. And remember, this is just practice. So there we have it. This one's called striping, which I didn't write down. I usually do. Kind of makes sense. Again, it's just a good filler. Just a great pattern that can be used to add drama or, you know, grab the attention of the viewer. Just a fun little piece. Our next one that we will do, this is a Tangleation, so a variation of another tangle that we did. So I'm going to start with my border. We always start with our border. This one's called Pepper. Don't mind my terrible handwriting. So with our Pepper Tangleation, what I want you to do, we're going to start with a curved line. You can start anywhere you want on your in your border. Kind of creating a stem, and then we're going to give ourselves a partial circle. But the one thing I do want to show you is finish that off and let it touch that circle that you draw. And the puppies are stirring. It's getting close to dinner time. Our next step, let's see how well you can see this. We're just going to start and do like a backwards C-shaped or U-shape to make it look like it is curved or rounded. And we're really just going to repeat that shape I'm just kind of starting at the top and curving it around to the side. So you can really have a lot of fun with this one. You can make it really big. Maybe you make it your focal point. Or maybe you've had enough and that's all you want to do. So once you get to the top, we're just going to add three little lines. And then top it off with a series of dots in the shape of a triangle. And we'll do one more of those just because it was fun. I have a hard time getting my lines to touch the top. So I will go in and fix that. This would be a good one to experiment with. So maybe this one. We'll hide a little bit. And really, if you wanted, this could almost be like the poke root that we did a few weeks ago. We could just create multiples of it. And if you really wanted, you could shoot out of your border like we've done with some of our designs. Now, obviously, I should have done pencil there, but, you know, it's just a fun Tangleation to play with. And I will go on to, I think we'll do two more. Since those ones were fairly easy. And then I'll show you what I've been working on. This next one's fun. It is called Kathy's Dilemma. I'm not sure why. So again, we're going to start off with another border. Probably could have made that a little bit bigger. It looks all right through my camera. Similar to what we just did with the striping, we're going to create a similar shape. So I would bring it down. However, the only difference is this last time we stopped here. This time, we're just going to carry it through the entire way. So our next step, really you can start anywhere. I'm not good at decisions some days. We'll start here. So we're going to create a series of triangles. I got some background music playing on Spotify and jumped to a commercial. So you're basically going to give yourself a series of triangles that act as a border. There we go. And this design doesn't really show like cutting them off. So you should try to finish them as much as you can. They generally stay the same size in this area. But again, I like to say there's really no wrong way to do these. So now we're going to jump to the middle part. And I think I'm going to start down here at the bottom. And then I'm going to work my way around. Not necessarily giving myself a straight edge on the bottom of the triangles. But if you're in a spot where you think you can do that, you are welcome to. So I'm just trying to make it fit like a puzzle. Don't hesitate to move your paper or your sketchbook around. I apologize if I'm making you dizzy. So I filled my space. And then the next step, if you want a thicker point, you can. I'm just going to use what I have. But they show little dots at the each point of the triangle. So you can go and add little dots. And then for the top part, you can do the same thing with the triangles. Although the smaller they are, the harder it is to notice. But what you can also do, you can go throw in some triangles to fill in those gaps. So it looks much nicer when you do that. Okay. And if you really wanted, you could just go in and add some sporadic dots throughout the design. Maybe I go in between every triangle here. That's a tight fit there. Maybe I give myself a bigger one there. You can also go in and add shading if you like. It's really your call. You could do something as simple as just shading the edges, and then we can go and blend it out if you'd like. I just really like the look of adding a little bit of graphite to our design. So if you don't have a tortillion, which is what I'm using now, you could take a tissue or paper towel and roll it up nice and tight and use that as a tool. You could also use your finger. So you can blend it out. Something like that. You could do it like the spears that we did and just give yourself a C shape there for shading. Or you can just play around like I'm doing. Not the best, but for a quick demonstration, not too bad. Just makes it pop a little bit. And I'm going to move on and just do a little watercolor demo for you. So let me find. Okay. So this is the one that I was working on the other day when I was with you guys. Now I painted this and kind of had an idea of what I wanted in my head. So I was able to add some circles. And I'm still working on it, not quite done. What I do want to do is go in and add some pencil to it here. And each little triangle shape within the circle pattern. Let's try it and see how it works. Pretty good. So I want to go and do this with all of these coins, I guess. I can't remember what the title of it is right now. I just wasn't sure how it would blend over top of watercolor, but it looks pretty good. It's pretty easy to blend out. However, word of caution, I would not do this until you are completely done with everything. Otherwise, you'll have pencil smudges everywhere because your hand's rubbing on your design. So if I could warn you there, that's one thing I would caution you on. I also want to go and add some shading throughout here. So it's a work in progress, but I'm getting there. So anyway, I wanted to do this one today. This is an experiment, so bear with me. I have my little handy watercolor set with all my pretty colors. I'll put my palette on there. And just something to important to remember, you know, you want to select your colors ahead of time and be mindful of, you know, using colors that will work together. So reference, here we go. I'm somewhat organized today. Reference your color wheel. And anybody have any preference? You know, if you want something that looks nice, you'll want to select colors that are close to each other on the color wheel. Or maybe you want certain shapes to really pop, so you might use complements. Again, a complement of red is green. You know, they're the opposite on the color wheel. Yellow, green, and red, violet. I think what I'm going to do, I might stick with my greens and my yellows and do something that way. So, you know, don't be afraid to reference your color wheel to find something that might work for you. But I would also recommend just experimenting with the use of color too, because sometimes you get some really cool combinations. I tend to do black for everything, because that's what I like. I have my handy watercolor brush here, so all my water is in here, and there's my brush. You might want to keep a paper towel nearby. I'm gonna wipe my brush off. A little bit of yellows from the other day in it. This, you just kind of give it a little squeeze. Whoop. And I actually leaked water out, so be careful. So my brush is pretty wet and I see some pencil marks. We'll let those go. It does smear the ink a little bit, not much. I think I'm going to try and get my palette in my, so you guys can see what I'm somewhat doing. Think of colors. Let's do some green. It's a nice green. Squeeze a little bit more water there. So it's a pretty fun, bright green. My brush is leaking. Probably because I don't have it on tight enough. It connects a little differently than... Instead of righty-tighty, it's lefty-tighty, and I just can't get the hang of that. Okay, so now I'm going into my yellow. I'm going to get some yellow going here. This is a nice, bright yellow. And if I'm not mistaken, it's already mixed with my green, so... I'm just going to go... over. I can tell you already, I prefer painting and then drawing on. But it's good to experiment and see how things work. I don't know, you probably can't see it so good, but the watercolors is covering my lines pretty good. I don't think I like that. But I'm going to go back and pick up some of my green. Actually, I'm going to blot that off. Yeah, go back to my palette and grab some green that way. Yeah, I don't, not a fan. I prefer painting it and then adding the color. But, I just wanted to experiment with what it was, how it worked. Just to see. Now I can offer a little advice. Your artwork might not always turn out so wonderful. It's okay to have pieces that are not fabulous. It happens. But the only thing I can tell you is you just got to keep trying. I'm going to blend my yellow and my green a little bit. Now maybe when this dries, I'll go over it again. I don't know. It's worth playing around with. You might prefer this method as to painting and then drawing your Zentangles. Uh-oh. Waiting for my dogs to bark, sorry. I'll apologize ahead of time. No, he's not gonna bark. My husband just came home and they hear him. So, anyway. There you go. Play around, have fun, add some color to your tangles. If you do not have watercolors, that's fine. You can try colored pencil, which I might prefer that to this method too. But play around and add color. And change it up a little bit if you haven't done so. So I'm going to quit right there. I feel like I'm going to ruin it if I go too much farther. Don't forget to step back and take a look at your work. That's pretty thick paint right there. Always step back and take a look and see if you like what's going on. It's always good to take a break. That's something that's very difficult for young painters. Sometimes myself, even, I get wrapped up in what I'm doing and I forget to step back and be like, okay, this is working, this is not working. So that is all I have for you today. We did three tangles, a little bit more color theory, and experimenting with painting with our tangle. So if you're creating anything fun or exciting, share it with me. You can share it here. or you can email it to us, or message us through our Facebook page, whatever works for you. And I will have class next Tuesday. We'll be here at 4. I hope you can join us. And if there's anything you want to see, feel free to let me know. Have a great weekend, everyone.